So, we are one the, let's say, older wolf of PNG.
Youngest, I'm the youngest.
Yeah, okay. When you start training Krav Maga?
Well, I started when I was around 11, 12 years old, something like that, back then in Israel.
So, how many years?
Since I'm not 35, so about 22, 24 years ago.
Okay. How was the training back in the days? Oh, it's different, of course, from nowadays, the training in Krav Maga. How was at
yes,
that time?
Yes.
What do you remember?
I remember that we didn't have much of equipment, so which means that luckily we was in a nice gym, so we already had the mats and so on, but we didn't have too much of equipment like shin guards and gloves and so on. Mm-hmm. So many times most of the training was done basically without any equipment.
Okay.
And even later on when we had, so usually the equipment will be put only for sparring.
Okay.
So which means we just, when you work, even the groin guard, you know, you defend yourself better and you trust your partner that will not hit you every single time. So usually protection will be put in only for the sparring, and that's when obviously.
Why did you start Krav Maga? What was the? I mean, I guess at that time was it not so well known.
Yes, the truth is, when I started Krav Maga, I didn't know what Krav Maga is. I just moved to Israel from back in Russia when I was all born, and then when I moved, just like always martial art and wanted to train. I was training some karate back in the days in Russia when I was 6 year old kid. So when I moved to Israel, I wanted to continue doing something. And I checked a few places, like karate and kokujitsu and so on. I didn't felt comfortable there, so it was not for me. And then I just was lucky enough to see like a program at the post office, and then it was near my home. So I went one class and then I just liked it and stayed forever.
Okay, when why did you stay? I mean, why didn't change for competition sport?
Because it's made sense to me. I mean, I always liked the reality, the common sense. I never wanted to be a champion or anything like that. So I was searching for it without knowing what I'm searching for. So when I came to Krav Maga, I just like, I didn't know that that's what I want, basically. So it makes sense, you know, there was no screaming, shouting, like in karate, every strike, which I didn't like. So it was just common sense. We do this because this is the reason. We do this because to survive on the street. We do this because, so it just made sense to me. I was like, cool, that's what I was searching for, basically.
And when you became an instructor, why did you choose to become an instructor? I mean, what was the trigger?
Again, because it was so natural progression for me. Again, I was 11 years old, started to train. Then my instructor said, why don't you lead the warming up? I'm like, sure, why not? You know, this and that. And then after a few times, he's like, did you thought to be an instructor? I'm like, do you think I'll be okay with that? He's like, yeah, sure, you can, you know, it looks, you have the potential. I'm like, okay, why not to try? And then I just started to be in love with it.
Okay. So the progression to become an international instructor was like natural.
Also does, yes. Luckily for me, again, I was just in the correct time and the correct place for me. So it was very natural. I mean, I just finished the instructor course and teaching civilians, and then went to the military. And then when I was about to leave the military, so again, I had... So Eyal and back in the days, Gabi just told me like, well, if you need a job and you want to do that, this is your option. We'll be happy basically to hire you. I'm like, sounds interesting. See the world and punch people and get money for that. Sounds like good business.
Okay, just last question. How is living so many days abroad? I mean, you travel how many days?
Average about 200 days a year.
Okay, so majority of the days you are abroad, not abroad. Yes. How is living like that? Or
it's amazing. I just always say that my home is where I am. So I'm able to see different countries, meet different people, hear different languages, try different food, do whatever I like to do, and I even earn money from that. So my life is perfect.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.